Feature Friday.
The freshest. Sup people, welcome to Feature Friday. Today is Friday and we are discovering brand new music for the first, very, very first time. And that's Indonesia. The territory of Indonesia.
We've actually
and
heard
Indonesian
some,
music.
We've actually heard some Indonesian artists before, like AGNEZ MO and Stephanie
what's Poetri. Actually, Poetri, that's her name.
Really?
Stephanie Poetri.
Okay,
yes.
Really?
In her, that's her artist name.
Oh, right, that's the name that I have. She did a song, Love You 3000, right?
Yes.
With Jackson, big man.
Yes.
And then we watched AGNEZ MO. It turns out I knew AGNEZ MO from, she did a song with Chris Brown.
Yes.
And then we also watched that video, which I thought it was like a dance video kind of thing.
We have here in this list some familiar names and some brand new names.
Nice.
So I and there's the most requested. So I hope you like it as much as I'm sure we will.
Yeah, enjoy our song actually, very nice. This is I think this one's gonna be
in Spanish.
Yeah.
Spanish, nice. And English. It's
in
like
Spanish
a little.
I think
little
the
mix.
Rap is all in Spanish.
Is it?
Think so. I can't remember.
Don't remember either.
Yeah, but this. I think your bit is all in English.
No. Nope.
It's all in Spanish. This might be a Spanish song. Regardless, though, it's really good. I really enjoy this one. Recording it was fun, so do give it a listen.
Cuenta la historia de un niño como yo que se hizo hombre y a su patria libertó.
Se llamaba Simón
Bolívar. Nosotros no somos nuevos. Es normal. Desde que tenía tres.
Entre tragos, cigarros, recordaba tu presencia. Ellos me decían que sola estaba en tu ausencia.
Ay, ay, ay. Bombo y caja. Era mi canción de cuna, sonaba en casa, me sonreía la luna. De grande quería ser rapero, casa fortuna, pero de ninguna manera salí como Zuna. Bombo caja, era mi canción de cuna, soñaba en casa, me sonreía la luna. De grande quería ser rapero, casa fortuna, pero de ninguna manera salí como Zuna. Dulce diosa de la melancolía, me aprieta fuerte con tu labio poesía. Farándula del eterno placer que me domina, decía, intraducible a causa de su prosa linda. Caía, constante guiño de las experiencias de la vida. Seguía y mira, te dedico esta poesía. Cuando te escribo en mi libreta estas letras, rimo letra y sales tú mi musa tan coqueta. No me creo en mil ideas en mi cabeza, pero en realidad soy solo un pobre poeta.
Desde pequeño recitando, canto, rapeando tanto, bailando al tanto, comprando santo,
matando gato, comiendo coco, sete en saco al mando, pato, sin ser narco o bailar al tango, gafo, yo ponía a la gente a bailar como si estuvieran marchando, no importa si es cata, salsa, merengue o guaco.
Decían que sola estaba.
other thing I was gonna say was that the way you guys send requests, because a lot of people sometimes ask, like, for, especially for the podcast, where you can send requests. Valeska usually does, well, it's the first time I've used your name probably. Walucha uses, she posts a community post before the day of the podcast, the day before the podcast.
Yeah.
And so on a Thursday. So you guys can send your sort of, you know, guide us through, you know, which music you think we would like and stuff like that. And then whichever has the most likes, or even if it doesn't, we still take it into account and then we try and come up with a list. And then we try and battle our way through copyright.
Basically, that is
just it. So you guys get to see it, you know, because it might get blocked. But if you do see edits and stuff like that, that's why.
Yeah, so, well, I think we can just go straight
yeah,
in.
Yeah, do it, yeah.
I think we can bang just it. Go straight in. Act so our first contestant of the night. I know he's not, but I just felt like I needed to say that. It's AGNEZ MO, long as I get paid music video.
So probably as long as I get paid, but if you take out grammar, right? If you just
looks, it sounds cooler.
Yeah.
Sounds and looks cooler, especially knowing how cool she is already. She's really dope.
Yeah, but if you misspell your,
you're not cool.
You're not cool.
You're just a dummy.
Yeah, you are. So, you know what I mean? It's like, sometimes grammar, it has its place. I actually feel the more grammar, the more gangster.
Really?
Yeah. Because mm-hmm. It's like. Yeah, it's like he means what he's saying, or she means what she's saying. But I understand this part. Go on.
Let's go.
Long as I get paid.
Oh, hello, place. Hello, shoeless man.
Barefoot man.
Story. Shoeless is better.
Even a statue has ass. Is that what everyone in the Indonesia is like?
Yeah, that must be like your daily life. Everybody looks like that.
Or a statue.
Or you get that view for a living. Whoa. She looks like Medusa.
Yeah, but yeah. It's like, it looks like Greece.
Oh my god, that looks fabulous. What a place.
This is the beginning of a movie. Introducing the villain.
Kind of gives me CL vibes.
Who's that? Oh, CL, right.
From 21.
Yeah. Looks a bit like, you know, an ostrich.
Long
like,
as I get picked. Because all the ostrich. Feathers.
Yeah, you know how they all like have those things.
An ostrich.
Yeah.
An ostrich is not un pavo real. An ostrich.
Oh, right.
An ostrich. An ostrich is an avestruz.
What's the one that has the beautiful feathers?
That has, is like, a peacock.
Really?
Yes.
Oh, well, you learn something new every day, don't you?
An ostrich. He called it an ostrich.
You know, like a thing.
Hey Siri.
A buitre.
Show me a picture of a peacock.
Peacock. It's a loaded name, bloody hell.
I couldn't find any.
Yeah, that's the one. That's the one.
Yeah, see, that's a peacock.
Brilliant.
Not an ostrich.
Find it incredibly rude that you are Siri instead of me, but in this case, it's forgivable. Go on.
Peacock.
It's a nice house.
And Sasha. She directed everything?
Nice.
That's cool. Oh, she's so bad. She's so beautiful.
Women and daggers scare me. Men and ooh, daggers scare me.
She's badass.
Whoa.
What
does
it sound
bass?
Like?
Bass? Oh no. Bass is heavy as hell. That's even more bass! That's fine. I think it's just the mixing of the song.
Ooh! I need to listen to this with headphones. Get my brain shaking.
That's a cool shot.
That's cool.
Oh boy. Don't do it, bro. Doesn't matter how attractive she is, don't get stabbed.
She's beautiful though. It might be worth it. Woo! He's just enchanted. He's under the spell. Ooh, how cool!
Ooh. Nice. I mean, she's very attractive. But the production is outstanding. She's money. Like, it's next level stuff.
She's screaming money and like outfits, production, the storyline, the visuals, everything is so congruent. Like the details of gold in the decoration with the details of her and her wardrobes. Everything is so beautifully thought through. I love that. The song is weird, but it's enchanting, and it fits the whole plot of the video. This is so elite.
The song reminds me of like, they have used this analogy before, but it's sort of like sirens music. Like, you know, sirens, those are mermaids.
No, it kind of reminds me of like chanting in a fireplace. Like, you know, like kind of like more like,
cult type thing.
Yeah, a bit.
Yeah, I don't know if it's a cult. I just
also
think...
gives me a bit of like Rihanna anti vibes.
Yeah, maybe. I just feel it's more like, you know those, you know when you play a video game, yeah? And then, what did I say, yeah? If you haven't agreed. But you know when you play a video game, and then there's this villain. What do you call a villain that's a female? Villainess?
No, just still villain.
They're just villain, right?
They're just villains.
Well, the villain.
Yes.
It's like this lady that's like, she like seduces you into the house, this mansion, and it turns out she's a vampire and kills you.
Uh-huh.
That type of thing.
Yes, well, that's the whole plot of the video.
She's not a vampire, though. She just likes knives.
But I think she might actually kill him.
Well, we're about to find out. That's kind of the vibe. It's sort of enchanting him.
Seducing him. Yeah, it's really cool, though. And brilliant model. God, he's gorgeous.
He looks like a good boy.
He looks like an American cop.
Nah.
He does.
Actually, maybe. Yeah, you're right.
He does. Probably. Go on. Ooh, she's so hot though, what the hell?
They're very attractive shots.
Ooh, boy, but the beat! Ah! Ooh, who's her producer?
That's brilliant.
That's brilliant! It's so hot. It's so cool. You know what? I actually thought some snakes were going to come out at some point.
Yeah, it's like that, isn't it?
It fits the whole plot, the whole atmosphere.
What do you call when you control a snake through the music?
It's like...
Whispering. No.
Snake, no. It's like... isn't it enchant? I don't freaking know.
Sort of like that, right? It's like snake chanting or whatever it is.
Yeah, I don't know what it's called. But
she's just good, though. It's very interesting. Like, the whole concept of it is eerie, weird... But very, like, you can't stop looking at it.
Yeah, yeah, hypnotizing at the same time.
And when that beat drops...
It's like, whoa, your brain shakes.
It's very good. I mean, the production is outstanding. No wonder she's very popular. I wonder, actually, if someone's watching from Indonesia, how popular is she in Indonesia? Because from all the messages you guys are sending, she's actually very popular worldwide. Like, mm-hmm. She's one of those people that... Yeah, she's really become mainstream. And probably because of the collaborations and her work is obviously awesome. But I'd love to know, like... If she is, like, the most popular singer in Indonesia, you know?
I think she might be amongst the most.
Because they have a lot of talent, actually. Yeah, they have a lot of talent that actually goes and works in Korea. They have a lot of talent that
is kicking butts in a lot dances. Of different parts of Asia. Yeah, definitely.
So that's why it was such an interesting country for me to sort of... It was my idea to try and listen. Why don't we find out Indonesian music? Because we've done some Indonesian artists, and we know some Indonesian artists from the Korean industry. So we were like, maybe the music industry there, it's rich, and obviously it is. So.
Yeah, it's crazy good.
Rich in the sense of value.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Let's...
Because they are very close to Philippines.
Yeah, they're relatively close,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Very close to South Korea.
Yep.
That area is...
Well, the whole Korean pop industry, right? It's very popular in all those areas. Mm-hmm. So, and sometimes they do grab talent from all these different places, right?
Definitely, definitely. So it doesn't surprise me that they have so much production going on.
And I'd love to, and I always say, you know, this is the blessing of the podcast and you guys, that we get to find out about every industry in the world, you know. So this is one that I'm definitely very interested about.
Yeah, for sure. I think, okay, yeah, the next one is Stephanie Poetri. And I know we've seen it, but we've never seen it live. And apparently this is like one of those performances that you have to watch.
Oh, brilliant.
Because I said to you guys who were sending me messages and stuff, it's like, but we've already seen it. We've actually seen two versions of this song. We've seen her solo version. We've seen
the one
with Jackson. And yeah, now we're going to see that live. But you guys were very
adamant
about
it. I'm always interested in watching live performances, so I don't mind, because life is life. It's actually true and raw and real. So yeah. This is interesting. Go on.
So apparently this is very, very good.
So. And I haven't heard that song in a while. So.
Yeah, it's a good song.
I feel important.
Baby, take my hand. I want you to be my...
That literally came out of nowhere. Like, she literally was like, yo, what's up? And now here we are singing like a sweet soft solo lullaby.
Very relaxed. Very
Just chilling. I like her.
Baby, take my...
I feel important.
Baby, take my hand.
I'm a fan.
Me too.
My husband, cause you're my Iron Man. And I love you 3,000. Baby, take a
She's
chance,
good.
Cause I want this to be something straight out of a Hollywood movie.
She's great.
Is where is the ring? Cause I know you want to ask.
I wish you all the success in the plan.
Me too.
I can see it in your eyes. Just take me by surprise. And all my friends, they tell me they see.
It's beautiful. Oh my god.
To get on.
Yeah, fantastic English.
But I want it.
Well, she speaks fluently, right?
Oh, it's great! This is fantastic!
I want you to be my husband, cause you're my Iron Man, and I love you.
Yeah, such a hit!
Baby, take a chance, cause I want this to be something straight out of
I love her.
Me too!
She's awesome!
Such a wholesome performer!
And baby, you're my winner. I see the way you smile. You're thinking about the eye. You reach in your pocket. Emotions are locking.
And she's great. Oh my god.
She was very approachable, very friendly.
Too fast. Oops. And all my friends, they tell me they see.
It's just great because it's so honest. Is like you see her really enjoying every moment of it. And you know what? I actually feel like a lot more people should have the freedom to be themselves on stage to this extent, like to really let their personality shine through regardless of where they are or whatever they're doing. And she is the perfect example of that. I think she really like just, you know, she's having a blast in the moment, and I feel like we're in her bedroom with her, you know, in that comfortable environment, and that is very precious. That doesn't happen often, so I like that.
She's a very interesting singer to actually study, because before stage performance wise,
yes.
Technically I don't know much about that, but stage performance wise, the reason why I find she's very interesting is because she, most people try to push away sort of the natural awkwardness of the situation, the natural pressure, the natural nerves and the uncomfortableness of the situation, but there is some magic that only a few actually are able to do. It might have to do with personality alignment, like what type of personality you actually have.
And but how comfortable you are in your own personality.
Yeah, but that's right. So not how comfortable they are on stage, but how comfortable you are in your personality, right? Like you really are aligned with your personality yourself, as weird as that may sound. But and there's some that can really dwell on this environment when they garner power through the awkwardness and weirdness, and just the fact that, like, there's cameras here, there's people watching me do what I used to do in my bedroom. They're paying me for this. There's a flash on, and that these lyrics are funny and light-hearted and heartwarming. I can't sing this like
Like a meant heartbreak.
Because it's not who I am.
Exactly. Right?
So I'm gonna sing it how I'm gonna sing it and how I wrote it.
Yeah.
You know, there's so much power in that, but only really a few people can
really pull that
play
off.
It right. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Because it's not something you can fake. Actually, it's very difficult to fake. So
that's why I think absolutely and vocally speaking, technique wise, she's got that falsetto really really down. You know, she's. I think it's obviously. The whole nature of the performance really is playing to all the advantages here.
Yep.
It's a very still performance. She can really play with the breath and she can really adjust the sound however she
brilliant
likes.
Sound quality,
but it's mixed beautifully. She's obviously very comfortable with the sound that is receiving. And it is just fantastic. I feel like I'm having an open conversation with my best friend in her room, you know, at 3 o'clock in the morning.
Someone
listening
you met
to
in
music.
High school and yeah. Still carried on contact with after college. And
absolutely.
Then...
It feels like I'm joining her in a sleepover and yeah, we're all yeah. Having a good karaoke party, fun type of stuff.
She's brilliant.
It's fantastic. What a great atmosphere she's building. Oh, it's beautiful.
It's because she's so loose, right? And relaxed.
Exactly, she's so relaxed. Ooh, great! It's so good!
And she's got nothing to prove. She's great, man. Spoilers, please. Yeah, sorry, mate. You won't like that movie. Yet. Well, not many songs she sung.
I love her, dude. Such beautiful melody. It just bounces right off her lips.
Good lighting in that place as well.
I love her. She's great. Freaking cool. Freaking cool.
I wonder. No way. He's from Indonesia.
Yeah, yeah, he is.
Really?
Yes.
From Jakarta.
No, she is,
but I'm saying the next one I just saw, but that's brilliant.
Yeah, he is.
But
great.
Stephanie, she, I wonder how many songs she sung there, and how many songs, or maybe if that was a show just for her.
Oh, it's like
it reminds me of Colors a bit. This show.
I was gonna say this is I don't know what's a trendy, but it's a live studio session.
What's
the
Korean one that you you showed me the other day, sort of put.
It's not like that because this is with audience. This is with a live audience in
brilliant.
It. So there is actually people that pay to watch you,
nice.
As they're live streaming it as well. So
nice.
it's a cool.
Is that
a
online
cool,
tickets as well?
I don't know. I think they film it and then they stream, like
nice.
They put it up. But yeah, it's like a live studio setting. It's like what you do in Colors, but with an audience.
That's awesome.
Mm-hmm.
Big supporter. What was it called again?
I think it's called.
You can see it there. You don't have to go back.
Are you feeling?
Bloodworks
Live Studios.
Right.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Well, props to them. Brilliant stuff.
Yep. Okay, Efra is like super pumped for the next one.
Yes.
Because we actually really like his work. Rick Bryan is such a cool dude, right? We actually came across.
Isn't
his
it pronounced
work.
Rich?
Rich Bryan?
Yeah, right.
I think it is. Yeah, you got it right.
<'Cause>
I don't know why.
It's spelled Rich, right?
I'm thinking in many languages in my head. It doesn't work. But yeah, I think it's Rich Bryan. And we actually came across his work because of Jackson Wang. And you guys recommended it really, really early on when we first started the reactions here in the channel. And I totally had forgotten that he's actually Indonesian until this special came up and you guys like, you gotta totally check out
sick.
One of his recent stuff. And this is Yellow.
So Jackson likes to...
Bekon.
Oh, maybe first time. Jackson likes to collaborate a lot with Indonesian artists.
Stephanie
and Rich Brian.
I think it's because they're signed with ADA Rising, and or they have friends in ADA Rising, right. So they both collaborate and work through them a lot. So ADA Rising has a lot of talents through, like, across Asia, like Chinese rappers, Indonesian people. Like, they've got a lot of people through in the whole of Asia, not just Korea. So nice. Yeah.
What's really interesting with Jackson Wang at the moment is that what I feel we might get to see is now that he's really become truly independent, really, because he's Team Wang, right?
And it's really, I think it's really gonna push in for that.
I think collaborations.
Internationalized.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. So maybe we'll get more international collaborations and stuff like that.
Yeah, I think so.
Because he was doing them when he was with JYP.
Mm.
So now, if that was, I don't know if that could have been a problem. I'm truly ignorant in that topic. But if it was, now obviously it isn't. So maybe we'll get to see more Rich Brian Jackson collaborations. I think they did, two?
I think they did a couple of songs. They've done a couple of songs.
I don't remember one, obviously. I don't remember what it's called. But it's where they're like in a car.
Titanic.
And then think they did one more, I'm not too sure. But he's good. He's a joke.
He's cool. We've seen a couple of his stuff off camera. He's pretty dope.
That looks like America.
This is America. ADA Rising, I told you.
A free
Joy production.
Free Enjoy.
Ah, okay.
Dave Mays, that's the same producer as Titanic, right?
I don't remember.
Me neither, I just made that up.
I love that. That is brilliant cinematography. Like, look at those filters.
Each house is a different story.
Oh, yes, turn up.
Next level.
Brilliant.
Whoa.
How eerie is that?
Turn again. Hey, sorry, turn this way.
Layered voices, this is me, tick, tick, tick.
I didn't know I could sing.
This is great, I'm going back to that layered. Brilliant.
So awesome.
Yes.
Oh. Love this guy, man. Please don't call the reverend, I don't need no help. He's won. He won the game of music.
Oh, this is good, good. Oh, brilliant! How cool is that?
Ooh, okay. That's
boy,
brilliant.
This is so good. It's eerie and it's haunting.
I like this guy a lot.
Whoa!
Jesus Christ, dude!
Whoa! That's creepy! I like that! Efra, I need lyrics. I'm not paying attention to the lyrics, and there is so much happening in the imagery. I'm pretty sure those lyrics are loaded. That's yellow. Rich Brian. That is freaking crazy,
you know,
dude.
You know who a collaboration would be amazing with? Have a guess.
Dean.
Yes. Dean or Tabba. Oh, or anyone from Dean's label.
You will know.
Dude.
Anyone from You Will Know.
That would be such a dream collab.
Yes.
So saying, how do I disappear without anybody knowing? Will anybody even miss me when I'm gone? Bottle full of liquor. I'm going to drown tonight. Life looks so easy. All you got to do is close your eyes. Please don't call the reverend. I don't need no help. Bury me a legend. I'm going to dig the grave myself. I can't remember when I last fell alive. Don't try to save my life. I'm already on my way tonight. The blood is on my hands. It's either do or die. Don't even try to save my life. Save my life. They gone memorize my name when I'm gone, and they gone recognize my face when I'm gone. Quite ironic, isn't it? Because actually, a lot of rappers, that's artists in itself, it's only when they pass away, really.
They become immortal.
Yeah, they realize that their work was truly immortal. But we realize that as an audience, because maybe they knew that as an artist. But it's very strange and bizarre, the fact that when someone perishes, especially if they had music at a specific level, right? That all of a sudden they get the most streams they've ever had, or they become the most trending topic for like a week.
One of my favorite artists that had a similar story is Jeff Buckley, right? Jeff Buckley was a nobody. Like, he was making music in America, but he was barely known amongst a small niche of alternative people in the 90s, right? And he tragically drowns in a river, and then his music becomes absolutely humongous amongst all the alternatives everywhere. Like, now it's a staple to say you listen to Jeff Buckley, oh, you're classy, you know? But you're like, dude, but when he was alive, nobody knew who he was. Like,
at least not to that level.
Exactly. Right. So, and I feel like that's happened a lot with a lot of artists. Like, XXXTentacion didn't actually blow. Tentacion didn't actually blow up until the tragedy happened.
It was ginormous, but he seemed to reach more people.
Like a new audience, you know?
When he unfortunately passed away.
Which is so bizarre. Like, how do you manage
same
that?
Story with Juice, same story with Nipsey Hussle. Actually, Nipsey is probably one of the most prevalent ones. Where, you know, even you know what I mean?
And but he was so influential in the hip-hop culture. And only the people, only the people that were hardcore into the hip hop would be like, yeah, Nipsey is like up there. And then,
well, it's because he figured out the game beforehand, right?
Yes,
independence amongst above everything else.
But a lot of people in the like that listened to mainstream music didn't know who Nipsey Hussle was until he passed away.
Yeah, especially you know? My generation, really.
Yeah, you know? Exactly.
Anyway, so he says, how do I disappear without anyone knowing? Will anybody even miss me when I'm gone? He says, bitch, hello. Don't fight the feeling because I'm yellow. Will it make it? Who the hell knows? Who the hell knows? You want my soul, but we don't sell those. Got a full clip. Don't even carry no guns. Nice. Don't need no ice. Feel like I'm 21. Nice. Breakfast and lunch. You're going to swallow my sons. Nice. Dinner, dessert. Eat these rappers for fun.
Everyone's like, approved.
Don't give me no fucks if you don't fuck with my shit. Rock 50 stages in all 50 stages, bitch. I did it all without no citizenship. To show me the whole world, you just got to imagine. Wow.
It's good, no?
It is good, no? On the day the bullets block out the sun, we are fools pointing out everyone but ourselves. Because we're the only ones to blame. It's insane because no one ever gets to change, or no one ever wants to change.
You know what's really funny, though? I feel like this is like an inner battle with inner demons and like depression and anxiety all compiled together, you know? Like, even though, I don't know, in the imagery at least, I feel like there's a lot of angst.
You feel trapped, right?
Yeah. And it's a constant battle to feel yellow, to capture the sun, to push through, you know?
It was interesting imagery, obviously. I'm not a big fan of the whole, like, scary, that type of stuff. But it's very interesting imagery, the fact that the hands were in his chest, throat
and coming and through his eyes mouth, and right? mouth. Yeah.
Didn't come through his eyes, did it?
No, his eyes were white. His
eyes were white, right? So he could no longer see, and he was being dominated by this inner hands, right? So this inner forces that shape the way you behave, shape the way you think, fears, anxiety,
the way you see things.
Yes. So,
or like to see things.
Yeah, so your inner demons is more concise way of saying it. That's what a lawyer would say. But so it's interesting then that he feels like those are the forces that have driven him into feeling trapped.
But then breaking through at the same time.
But also the same forces that pushed him into breaking that glass, which was actually very breakable.
And it was just a matter of taking that step.
Yeah, and now he's finally seeing some color, right?
And not just seeing somebody through the glass.
In the very beginning, he's trapped in film.
Yeah.
So he's breaking free slowly, but not free through positivity. He's breaking free. That's what I'm saying.
Through a lot of struggle and like inner battle. It feels like an inner battle. Yes. Like it's.
And he recognizes. He says, "I'm 21."
Yeah.
No, he feels like he's 21. So it's there's.
He's 21.
He's 21. Oh,
he's
okay.
He's a young fella. He's a year younger than me. I don't know when this was released, but...
This is relatively new. Yeah, this happened in
2019. So he's probably 22 now, so he's probably my age. We're the same age, probably. But it's that feeling. It's like...
You know, it's really clever imagery, and the lyrics are fantastic. Obviously, this beat production and sound engineering in this track are absolutely insane. I'm a sucker for... great vocals and layered harmonies, and this is just everything that I wanted and more. It's insanity. I love it.
Serious. There is some odd power in darkness and struggle. You know, some real odd power in there. It's just a different polarity of butterflies and sunlight.
But it can really push you through. There's a really bizarre source of strength that can really power you through.
It's just another source of power, right?
Yeah. It's not an easy path though. Like, you really gotta be strong mentally.
No, hell no.
But sometimes
you don't have a choice.
Yeah.
Sometimes you were just born poor. You didn't win the lottery of life. Sometimes you were just born in a third world country. Sometimes you were born in countries in war. Sometimes your parents left you. Sometimes you were adopted and you just were playing the game from behind.
Yeah.
Sometimes you just when born with any skills or any natural ability to do anything, so you got to figure that stuff out, right? So there's some odd power in struggle too, which I think a lot of people underrate, you know?
Well, it makes for the most inspirational stories. That's
I like this
sure.
fella a lot.
Me too. What a cool video! That is so eerie. I love it. I'm guessing this is Bekon.
Yeah, the vocals.
Bekon, sorry.
I don't spam the video.
Ooh, I love it. That's dope, dude.
That is brilliant.
That's a great video.
It's live, right?
I see we're seeing what was actually happening in the outside world when he was going through that battle. That's what I get to see. This is what was actually happening in the world outside of his head, and the beginning is what was really feeling and eating him up the whole time.
Right, yes.
You know? At least that's how I see it.
I think you could be right. It could also be interpreted as then what his life has been, and then I think we're about to find out what the end is.
Oh,
where he's at.
This is the fire video!
That could be
what
fun
a
as
great
well.
Video, dude! It's so profound. The imagery is crazy deep.
Okay, interesting. So now, the sailor. 7th, 26th. Is that those are the album released.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm gonna check that album out.
God.
Interesting, interesting. So there was no resolution then, but the resolution, because I don't know how to interpret it, whether this was the life he has lived, well, which is obviously that's probably what it looks like, right? While he was battling those inner demons.
Mm.
And now he's, because the song has a huge emphasis on nobody wants to change, right? Yeah. And I, actually, when I was in school, there was a, we had a writer as a teacher, and she would write she'd write a few novels and stuff like that, and she would help us decipher movies.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, because she also directed some stuff, small like movies and stuff like that. And then she always used to mention that, I'm not sure if this was the intended purpose of this, mm-hmm. but she mentioned that every time we see a scene where they're throwing up, right, mm-hmm. they resembles change. Mm-hmm. In most movies, they utilize that as cleansing and change.
Yeah.
Like usually, you would see movie, someone throws up, it's like hungover, and then something different is going to happen the next day.
Yeah.
Because they have felt the consequence of their actions.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Obviously, it's a way more profound scene just throwing up or being hungover, but because it's art and movie,
it is.
Usually has a different meaning. But so I don't know how to interpret it, whether he's going to change that part of his life and attempt something different, or he has been able to live that life only because of the demons that he had inside. So there was some element of fun, enjoyment, cathartic pleasure in pain and fight and blood and girth and raw sex.
We need to wait for the part two.
Yeah, it feels like they need a second part, like a resolution to it all. It actually wouldn't surprise me if this is it, you know, because it is like,
as humans... Well, it's definitely an album, right? It's probably a story.
You never know. Yeah, definitely. It's definitely intricate. It's definitely thought-provoking. And that... I feel like that closing scene of him outside of a burning house that used to be his holds a lot of power.
His home, of course, yeah.
But your home is burning. And it kind of like by your own doing. So it's... I find like there's a lot of depth here and I need to go...
Burning represents his own life.
Yeah, it could... Yeah, totally.
Again, I always keep... people always send me messages for this, but like humans have an amazing capability of rising like a phoenix from the ashes.
Absolutely.
So that could also mean that. I have nothing left. My home is burnt. I have nothing. I've left everything behind. I'm willing to change now.
Well, I don't know. Let us know what you thought about it. What are your theories of this song?
Yeah, he'll be an interesting individual to speak to. I'd love to find out maybe if he has interviews or whatever, or maybe he's spoken about this. It'd be brilliant to
find out. Him or the director have somehow broken this video down, would be fantastic to watch something like that.
Yeah, they're also welcome to do it here as well.
Maybe. They're also welcome to come into the podcast.
Yeah, for sure.
Anyway, so this was so cool. I'm really like kind of blown away. So, okay, so next we have two ladies from Indonesian Idol. You know, like American Idol, like Latin American Idol, like they used to do it in South America. So this is the same program, but in Indonesia,
yep.
And it's actually fairly recent. It happened in 2020, and this performance in
very popular,
very, very well regarded. Actually, they're like two very solid singers.
Oh, let's give it a go. Yeah, why not?
Yeah, So it's Tiara and Raisa.
Again, I apologize if we're pronouncing names wrong. We're obviously learning and
definitely.
Guide us in the comments. We read every comment.
Yeah, please do. Thank you. Let's have a little look.
Kali Kedua. Kali Kedua.
Ooh, look at that stage.
Look at that set, Father. Look at that. Oh, you missed it.
I love that you put all the sponsors in the video. That's great. That's brilliant lighting engineering, though.
You see that? That's a joke.
Crazy, no?
It's beautiful jewelry, actually.
Makeup's perfect, it matches the lighting, it's great. Great. What a great dress. Look at that dress.
She looks great, that lady. Wow.
My God.
Jesus Christ.
Who is she? Dude,
is that
what?
Is that Raisa?
Raisa? Raisa?
I don't know if in Indonesian it would be better to just pronounce them
things
with
like
Spanish
like
pronunciation.
We do in Spanish. Raisa.
Yeah, with an R. I don't know. Please, if someone speaks Indonesian or is from there or knows a bit about how to pronounce their names, do let us know in the comments.
But she is absolutely fire. Oh my God. She's very comfy, dude.
She's like, a bit older, like 20, like 27, 26. She's a bit older. She does.
She looks absolutely stunning as well. That's like totally diva energy,
yeah, yeah. Well,
you know,
maybe diva's not the right word, but I do understand what you're saying, like just powerful.
Yeah.
I mean, that is kind of what diva means, right?
Without the attitude. Yes.
I just relate diva to that, like
yeah, like just take all the positive
parts
side
of
that. Yeah.
You do be whatever you want on stage, mate. It's for yours. You know
yeah,
what I mean?
Yeah, but she's amazing. It's gorgeous.
I think that's Raisa.
It's like, here, is this camera?
She's very pretty too.
Ah, but what a voice! Oh, she's such a star. Such a soft, velvety vocal. It's so warm, but it's so effortless at the same time. It's, wow, it's.
Can I know how old they are?
Treat.
You know how to spell it? Tiara as in tiara, and then Raisa as in Raisa.
From like how we would do it in Spanish. Raisa.
Not much information
about it. Okay.
Right. They're pretty new, right?
Just put Indonesian singer. It might come up like that.
Yeah, go on.
It's brilliant. Oh, what a beautiful run.
Yeah, she's very powerful. They're both great.
Oh, beautiful. I know.
Interesting voices.
Yeah. Awesome. That was great. What a cool performance. You know, it's really interesting because the lady in the black dress, she's got a nice warmth and velvetiness, and her high range is kind of like sounds effortless, but there is that power as well. But I feel like her power comes from like the lower range, like more resonant, more alto range.
She seems to be very resonant, yeah.
Yeah, and the lady in white, it's, I feel like she's got more power on the beltier side of things.
I think
like
it's Tiara, yeah.
Yeah, I think so too, but I don't want to say wrong name, yeah, so yeah. I'm sorry. But yeah, they're incredible, dude. They've got so much, and it was really interesting, those harmonies as well, like where they chose to harmonize. Yeah. Mm.
And that was live as well.
Mm.
But they in a very intriguing way juxtapose each other because they're similar color, is that what you say?
Texture. Yeah, vocal texture, yes. But
yeah, like I'm guessing it's Tiara, the lady that's a bit shorter. She adds such sweetness.
Definitely.
Right? Which doesn't go with a singer that it's like what have you described as a diva. They usually don't have that. You know, they go towards other things. They could have the ability to do so, but that's not what their performance is. But then when you have a duet, you don't have to try and be sweet and create sweet melodics and stuff like that when you have someone else that can do it. So it's very, it was like, that. At some point, it was also that thing you always say, like unison. It was a lot of unity going on at the same time. But you could also pick off really easily who's who and who's doing what.
Definitely. It was brilliant. Nice brilliant performance, really. I really enjoyed that. That's really nice. If you have any more songs from either of them live Tiara or in studio, either Tiara or Raisa, please let us know down in the comments below. We would totally check them out. They are incredible.
I want to know their age. Pick it off. Actually, any women or men, as a matter of fact, from this part of the world, from that part of the world, I can't guess. Because they never age.
Yeah, good
they
point.
Just don't. I don't know what's around that part of the world. I don't know what they
drink. It's like the water's different.
But they don't age. They age twice. They age three times, sorry. When they're zero, right, until they're like five.
Okay.
Right, they age. They actually, one to two, they age. Because then you become a toddler. And then they stay the same until they're like 12. And then from 13, 12, 14, they stay the same until like 57.
And then they change.
It's just their body changes. You maybe get a bit taller, you know, all that stuff. But and then they age again at 60. And that's it.
It is so weird. Like, honestly, Asia men has been same. Blessed with like the unaging gene.
Asia's
it's
nuts.
So crazy. Anyways, moving on from another live acoustic nice. Performance that has been really, really requested was NIKKI Lala Lost to You. And this is live in an acoustic like studio.
Brilliant.
And people have been raving over it. So this is also our first time to listen to some of this.
Let's do it. So, I love acoustics in case you're new to the channel.
So yeah, let's go.
Please.
Look, listen to that. Really? Head in the clouds.
I like listening to those lips part.
What almost so sad are you on the subway? What that drive are you getting on?
God, that mic picks up everything.
Me and Manhattan's nice.
Those are like podcast microphones.
Yeah, that's the
that's a short something.
Seven, whatever it's called.
Yeah. Those things literally pick out the air moving.
Yeah, but I really like the detail you can hear, especially at the beginning, like those days, like her lips parting,
the
fingers,
the breathing,
the fingers playing on the guitar.
The literal chit-chat, everything is so great. I'm going to put it again.
Atmospheric.
I like it already. I like her earrings. They're pretty cool. You ready?
Okay.
See, ADA rising.
Well, I'm so sad, are you on the subway?
See, she could be 18 or 35.
And you would never know.
On the L train, me and Manhattan's nice. So Malibu night. You will know if you stay.
Beautiful.
You will know if you put up a fight.
Oh, it's good.
In winter, I'm getting red rum.
This is what we like.
Took for all of the things left unsaid. I'm missing my drunken 2 a.m. strolls in Cape Town.
I want them engineers in my house.
Fucking on Brooklyn's in Brooklyn. Your Chelsea's in Chelsea. Hope that eases the pain. So you remember to miss me. And you sold your car. Now you walk for miles.
Nice, man.
Feel numb. Crosswalks in my mind are shaky, so please hold on tight.
She's awesome.
How good is she? This is brilliant. Soft, tender, raw, very vulnerable, very open for mistakes. This is a moment where being human is the pinnacle of the entertainment right here. Like, is the breathing, is the talking through the song, is the feeling of the strings through the fingers. You can literally feel the air in that atmosphere. Honestly, I want those sound engineers to come to my house.
Oh, and the production
just make me listen to my life through pretty sounds.
It's elite. This is very, very top-notch stuff. Go on, keep going. Please.
Literally. Oh.
All my demons run wild. All my demons have your smile.
It's nice earrings as well.
City of angels. Of angels.
Interesting touch though to the outfit.
Hope New York holds you. Hope it holds you like I do. While my demons stay faithful.
Nice.
In the city of angels. Summer's ending now and the nights are cooling down. Remember last winter when we were
that G7, is it?
Oh, she's brilliant. Such great melody.
No one alone. Driving through no hope. If I'm honest, I call. But I'm trying to let go.
I like her a lot.
Me too.
Live life in taxis. You'll always have me. You'll always have me. All my dreams run.
About LA, isn't it? Mm. Find any angels there?
Yeah, it's a really cool. In the first verse, I was like, she's talking about the city of angels, but she's also talking about the L train in New York City, Brooklyn, and all this stuff. And you're like, I was a little lost in
wait,
the
it's a story. It's in a the story space. Long distance love, right?
Yeah.
She's left.
In New York, and she lives in LA. Yeah.
Well, he's left her or, for something, for work, for whatever, traveled somewhere else.
No, I actually feels like a long distance relationship where he has been unfaithful, and that's what it sparks the whole
doubt.
No, the pain in the song.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, but I was just saying that it's ironic, isn't it? Like, L.A.
It's really no city of angels.
It's full of little devils, actually.
They're actually
fun people, ones. Yes,
people
indeed.
That live in LA say that LA is not nowhere near anything where dreams come true or nothing. Which, you know,
don't know about that. But
we would have to go and find out for ourselves.
Yeah, don't know about that. But I'm just saying, all the
yeah,
all the people I've met through that live in LA, it's like. It's not an angelic city. Like, it's not a city of holiness, because it's called a city of angels. You know what I mean? It's a city of it's different. It's not. It's exactly the opposite of angels.
Mm.
You know, and it's a different experience. But it's so ironic that because of that name, that city has become like that.
Los Angeles.
You know what I mean? That's so crazy.
Well, that's what's what it's called.
It's because it could be called it's something else. I don't know, the cucumber city, whatever. You know what I mean?
And there's no cucumbers in your cucumber city.
And then it wouldn't be as impactful, the fact that adventures and mischief and lovely adventures too, and also, you know, bad stuff and the lust and cheating with all these, you know,
twisted things
and also positive things, you know, like partying and meeting people and energies and stuff, but it all happens there, you know. And then if you actually want to, and then the bigger version of that without a beach and just shitty weather is New York.
New York City, yeah, that's, you know, right.
So it's also interesting that those are the two cities she's talking about, right? Because I tend to believe, not, I don't believe this, but I tend to observe it, that people that live in a city take on the city's personality as well.
Absolutely. 100%.
The city's kind of like
mannerisms. Yeah, of course, yes.
Because, like, for example, let's say London, let's say Paris, right? So London is a very particular city.
Mm-hmm.
And it has particular ways.
Yes.
Paris is a very particular city and it has very particular ways. And people from Paris behave differently, not because they're from France, but because they live in Paris, especially big cities like this. Same as New York.
Mm.
People from New York are different from people like Michigan. They're both American, but the city changes.
Yes.
It's obviously because we adapt in the environment. But so maybe in LA, you become a bit more, I don't know,
aligned with emotions and feelings rather than,
because you're so exposed to extremes. Hard reality.
So the dynamic of every city creates marks and people behave.
Yeah, absolutely. And then in New York, you know, people in New York are a bit faster, a bit more of the pace.
The pace is super fast.
So then maybe that's why he doesn't see it the same way as she does.
Absolutely.
Because his life, it's non-stop in New York. It keeps going, it keeps changing.
And not that life is stagnant in LA, but it has a different, like, time moves differently, you know?
I don't know.
It does.
It's just weird, isn't it?
Yeah. I really like this song. Oh my God, it's great.
Hope New York holds you. Hope it holds you like I do. While my demons stay faithful.
Really, camera work as well, it's fantastic.
Yeah, yeah, everything is just 10 out of 10 here.
Yeah, I agree, yeah. Well, she has a whole saga of it. Shouldn't, couldn't, wouldn't.
I like her. I want to hear her whole album. That's it.
Click on
she
that one.
She bought me.
Click on that one. Shoulda, coulda,
she
wouldn't.
She bought me.
I like her a lot. It must be rough seeing a friend go through that stuff as well.
Yeah, definitely. But doesn't it feel so real? Like, it feels so like, it's true. It could happen to literally anybody. Like, what she's talking about is 100,000 other people's stories at the same time, you know?
I guess because it could, right?
Because it is. Yeah. I'm pretty sure a lot of people are going through similar stuff. And, you know, those cities have so many people inside.
And it's so
crazy that one person can
encapsulate
like so many people's stories in a 3-minute song. It's so relatable for so many thousands of people, and even for people that have never gone through it like me, I feel like I'm in it with them, you know. It's cool. What a cool songwriter. I like her.
Well, this one is 2:40 seconds long, 2 minutes 40 seconds at least.
Shouldn't, couldn't, wouldn't.
Go on.
We're playing in B, yeah?
All right. Hey! It's all about the zodiac signs,
no,
brother.
But what did she say about Geminis?
I
does
guess
she
want to
fight?
No, listen.
What did she say? She's a Gemini.
He's a Gemini.
Oh, God, here we go. More shitting on us. Because sign. Go on.
Love it. Fantastic, fantastic.
She has the same song with Rich Ryan.
Oh, the same song with Rich Brian.
Oh, brilliant.
Oh, my God. Guess what we're going to be doing tonight? Ah, that is fantastic.
So how old is she, father?
No information about
bloody
her.
Hell.
No information about her.
I just think you...
She is cool as hell.
It's okay. It doesn't really matter.
I really, really like what they're doing here. I think everything that's happening really is just... Everything we've watched, it feels a little... Feels a little unreal, you know what I'm saying?
Well, it's brilliant. I'd love to know, you know what? What's the actual, is it actually called Indonesian, like the language?
No, they've got different sets of...
Dialects?
Dialects, right. Yeah, they come...
700 different languages in Indonesia.
What do you mean, language?
Like dialects from...
Is it like the Philippines where they have like
languages? Oh, right. Oh, wow. My God. So
is that why a lot of them speak English then?
Yeah, I was going to say, what's the official language in Indonesian?
Or the most spoken one. Maybe, because all these guys, well, they obviously live in America, most of them, but Rich Brian, I don't know where he lives.
I think he did live in America. I don't know. I don't know
that much about that video was definitely him. Shot in America, the one that we saw.
Yeah. Yellow.
Yeah, yellow. I don't know if the rest was... Yeah, there was too many Americans. There wasn't enough.
It's... Listen, everything is...
Well, American-looking people, at least.
Wow, this is cool. Anyways, to close it all off...
Yeah, go on.
We got Weird Genius with Tabitha. Tabitha Nauser?
Or League of Legends. This thing again.
Is it from the League of Legends? Yes, it is. So and it's called All In.
All In. There's this thing, yeah, like League of Legends, like they
like do the some of the saga. Most,
yeah, amazing music for a game I think I've ever heard in my life.
And not only music, but like the animations and the display videos. Of video, yeah, the videography is like crazy insane.
Ridiculous.
And they really hook you up, like they really get you interested in the game. Well, let's
give it a watch.
So cool. this is from that. This
League
is
of Legends World Rift.
All In.
John.
Oh, this is like an actual video.
It's an actual video, right.
Oh.
It's like a promotional track. Weird Genius is the DJs, right?
Yes. She's got swag.
Dude, I was speaking in English, so.
Got a beautiful voice.
Oh, it's like
how cool! I like that.
Like dressing up, right?
Yeah.
Got like a tail, damn. Hey,
they're
there they are.
Cool. They're cool as hell. Dope.
Such a weird beat. Weird Genius.
It fits the whole aesthetic of the game too. Like the,
well,
the
game. I've never seen it.
No. But like
I've seen
the
it,
video
but...
with the game and the sound and I don't know. I think it really works.
That's a small detail.
Yes.
She's not from Indonesia.
She's not from Indonesia. She's from Singapore.
She's from Singapore. So Tabitha, or maybe Tabitha.
Tabitha.
She's from Singapore, and then Weird Genius are from Indonesia.
Yes.
Oh, right. See. No, the Weird Genius are from Indonesia.
Yeah, they are. That is cool.
Right.
I like the internationality of it all.
Maybe then next place to fly to is Singapore. Music wise, by flying in our couch
from here.
London's still in lockdown.
Let us know if you'd be interested in that. This is cool though. Yeah.
She's 28 years old.
She's 28.
Right.
Cool.
See, she looks 21. She looks about 24 actually. Fire that's
inside is to I really like her voice. It's dope.
Those eyes real.
No. This cosplay is the contacts.
That's so catchy, what the hell?
Oh, what the hell?
Yeah, she's pretty too.
She's gorgeous.
Nice.
That is so cool.
wish I knew where they were dressing up us. That's a short and a half.
That's in a helipad. How sick is that?
Yeah, how the hell did they come up with that random beat?
Yeah, they're really cool like that. That is really like out there, different. It really is different. I don't feel like I've heard anything like that before. It's pretty dope. It does fit the whole idea of like a video game. I like that. It's
very
cool.
Video game.
Yeah. And I think, is it, I don't know, can you guys let me know, please, pretty please, if in like League of Legends, can you actually create your own avatars? I think that's what it is. Like, I think you can create your
avatar. No, what it is, yeah. So you choose, there's like different,
like worlds.
It's just like, you can be like a healer, or you can be like a battler, like, what do you call it, like a warrior.
A battler.
I don't know what it is. I think that's what it is. And then you choose which faction you want to be part of. And then there's specific characters you can be from there. And then you can upgrade them endlessly. And it's kind of like, I think these games are like based on grind. So you basically have to
play a lot of hours
to try and receive one item that's like legendary and stuff like that. Again, I'm very ignorant in this stuff. I haven't played video games in years, but I think that's what it is.
I used to
play a game like that with my friends when we were in school, and it was actually free. You could pay to win.
Warframe.
We used to play that in high school, and there was like rankings, and it was like a proper thing. And we would get very into it. Like, we would fucking game until nighttime, and you could upgrade your characters and make them look differently. Mm-hmm. And you could also get new characters and new suits and stuff like that. And it was all online. You could never play. I mean, you could play offline, but most people just enjoy playing online. And then you would do missions together. There was like clans and big people that would run stuff. And then they would have like parties. Like a party is like a group chat.
Okay.
And then you would talk to them and stuff. And then look, I'm going over here, I'm going over there.
Oh, that's so dope.
And then the bigger the mission, the more people
that could go in. Cool.
So then you would have like an army of like 10 against the whole level, and then you try and beat it and stuff. Yeah, I would play with my high school friends and stuff. Yeah, it was like just school friends, really. You know what I mean? So, and then we would just hang out for hours. And then we would always see this person who was like, wow, that guy has like the best stuff.
That is so cool. Yeah.
You could buy it as well.
You could definitely tell I'm not like a gamer. I don't have a clue. It's really cool though. I'm
guessing
like,
it goes along those lines.
I you know, but based on the music videos that we have seen from League of Legends, a lot like they really give me interested in the game, and then I figured out like I wanted to see more about the game so to see if I could play it, because the videos
look
so
anything
cool.
Like it, though.
But it's nothing like the videos. That is just like, wow. Music school.
Why don't we watch, Vale? There's this lady called Rossa.
Yes.
Rossa. She it's just because I received so many messages while we were having the podcast. And she's actually collaborated with, they've done them and Ryuk from...
apologies, Super Junior.
Yeah, if I'm pronouncing the name wrong. For Super Junior, they've done stuff together. Rossa with a double S.
Okay.
And I want to know who she is.
Super Show 7, isn't it?
Yeah, sure. Not friends.
No, bad.
It's called Tega. No, just one G. A-R.
A-R?
Yeah, just... There it is.
In Jakarta.
Go on.
Let's go.
There's Ryuk and Yisun.
Oh, look, there's one here. Oh, no, let's watch this one. This one looks proper. One,
yeah. Yeah. But that one's more popular than the one you clicked.
Maybe
better. Maybe the resolution's better.
I don't know. It's definitely more popular.
Go on then. Just click on that one. But it only has a million views. Go on. Whoa, we're really getting the whole experience here.
I love Super Junior, dude. I love him.
You got the flash.
Light sticks, Efra.
Sticks. Why are they all walking to the left?
I think she's on the other side of the stage.
You can walk? You're trampled. Oh, there
he is. Yes, sir.
They're great singers, dude. They're such good singers.
And they're like that in real life.
Wow. They got like light swords, these ones.
Ah, it's beautiful.
It's amazing. There she comes.
I love being in the audience like this.
I'm guessing it's a she, right? We're like, oh my god. That is that thumbs up. Wow. Kind of people scrambling at the back of the house.
Oh, I love them, they're great. Together, they work so well. Wow. Together is just outstanding.
They're insane.
I know, look at how they look at her.
I think there might be more.
Super Show 7.
Little hug. It's a human touch. Oh, right, so the translator, right?
Here's the cool thing about...
They translate?
Yeah. Here's what? The cool thing that happens with K-pop bands that go abroad. They have translators in the show.
And hype men as well, hype women. They're like, let's go! They just said blah, 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 and then everyone gets pumped, right?
No, it's just a translator. So whatever they're not hyping.
Because you got to say... Ryan Wick said, everybody stand up, put your hands together, and clap like there's no tomorrow. Then the guy comes in.
The translator
like,
will be
please
like,
clip your hands together.
Of course.
Like, we're fucking doing this.
Yeah,
fucking
they match up the energy. But they have translators. And I would
add swear words just to add impact.
I've only seen that in K-pop concerts. Like, I've never actually seen that in other stuff. And it's pretty cool, though. Like, they have, like, in the, like, as the concert is progressing, whatever they're saying to the fans, it's like the translator would go ahead and change.
It's a proper experience.
It is. That's crazy. So, like, the audience doesn't miss out on absolutely nothing. How cool is that?
Nice. I think there might be the Korean industry might be the only one that's doing that, like Korean bands. I don't know, maybe let us know if there's any other bands that do that translation live.
Translation. I've at least that's the only place I've seen it. Like, yeah. Perhaps other people are doing it as well, but I'm just
wondered, right?
Totally like, ignorant.
Say you're like a band that speaks only in English, and then you go to Finland or something, and then they don't know a word of English. They don't really know what you're saying.
But you know,
same as Korean.
Here's the thing, though. I remember I used to watch like big bands. I don't know, freaking, I can't think of a band right now that I used to. Oh, Journey. right? And you would see their DVDs of like their world tours when they would be like, I don't know, in Germany, and they would say like thank you in German, and the rest of it would be in English. Yeah. And people would still go crazy. It was like, okay, no, take your shirt off, and everybody would be like, yeah, hell yeah, and they don't know what they're saying,
of course, you know.
So I always thought that was just how the rest of the world did it.
I think the worst one has to be then when you're a stand-up comedian. Like if someone like Bill Burr or Kevin Hart or Joe Rogan, Dave Chappelle,
I don't know how they do it.
They tour worldwide sometimes.
How do they do that?
And they go, like Bill Burr, he went to like Scandinavian countries. He was like in Norway or something. And then they don't know what are English, you know? And he's like, yeah. And my jokes are landing.
And my jokes.
Because some of them know the jokes because, you know, he does similar routines.
Like, just I guess new material, like, yeah.
Just new material for that specific gig, but he does also similar jokes to certain stuff, I think, and people laugh and they land and people like, I understand, and you're like, what the? But you don't speak a word of English.
I know.
But they still go, and, you know what I mean?
So, that is so crazy.
You can't have a translator when you're a stand-up comedian. It kills the vibe.
It's like just have the Finnish translator
be yourself. You know what I mean?
Yeah, be the guy.
But anyways, yeah, this is really cool. I just wanted to watch out because I basically as we were coming, my watch kept flashing. Rossa.
Well, so. Here we are. She definitely is somebody to watch. And if you have a video of her that it's on a better quality sound wise, that we could totally get to appreciate the magnificence of her vocals. Please let us know and drop it down in the comments below. This was so fun. Yeah, I absolutely adore this.
Brilliant.
This was so great. Again, thank you so much, guys, for your brilliant suggestions.
Yeah, and you know, it's difficult to make a list, especially, with copyright and all that stuff. So if there's something that we couldn't cover here, we do Feature Friday extra on Monday. So just if we didn't get your suggestion, just put it in the comment below. We'll try to watch it. And they will go on the channel regardless. So everyone, you know, gets a chance to get their suggestions seen. And most of the suggestions are brilliant. So it would be our pleasure, you know.
Yeah, don't forget that our merch is out and available.
Yeah, if you want
now,
these joggers, yeah.
Look at them.
Stop saying joggers. See this?
Oh my God! Look at that. It's drip.
They're actually what makes this outfit work.
Yeah, basically.
Yeah, but it's a shame you can't just see most of it on camera. So maybe I should sit here.
No, don't.
And you can't see my face. See how this.
Anyway, so yeah, if you would like to get your type of merch, this kind of cool merch, yeah, you can just click on the comment below or directly into our shop link. That's probably somewhere in the channel. And yes. Yeah, I don't think you can even see that.
I see it. Anyways, peace.
Bye-bye.